What's up, party people? It's Keys Dan with RadioWhat.com, DJLittleRock.com, coming to you live in a living color from the Radio What Studios, and this is my podcast, What Makes You Smarter. It's an extension of the RadioWhat.com internet radio station that I've been running for quite some time, and if you need DJ services, where do you go? DJLittleRock.com. DJLittleRock.com, check availability and get a free price quote right there. And maybe you can have me entertaining you at your next event. Let me entertain you. And if you'd like to tell your story, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Find it everywhere using the hashtag What Makes You Famous. Let's learn some stuff right here on the program. Now, on with the show. Today on the program, 10 things you need to know today for Thursday, January 30th, 2020. 10 things you need to know today. Number one, senators question both sides in new phase of Trump trial. President Trump's impeachment trial entered a new phase on Wednesday as senators began questioning House managers and Trump's legal team about the allegation that Trump withheld security aid to pressure Ukraine into investigating Democrats. Defense lawyer Alan Dershowitz said even if a president tried to trade military aid for political favors to help him win re-election, quote, it cannot be impeachable, end quote, if he thought getting re-elected was in the national interest. Republicans are pushing to wrap up the trial quickly, while Democrats and a few key Republicans are pressing for testimony from new witnesses, including former National Security Advisor John Bolton. Senators will continue questioning House managers and Trump's legal team on Thursday, with a vote on whether to call witnesses expected Friday. This is according to the Washington Post and the Associated Press. Number two, Trump National Security team threatens to block Bolton's book. The White House has told John Bolton's lawyer that the former National Security Advisor can't publish his book as written because it, quote, appears to contain significant amounts of classified information, end quote, CNN reported Wednesday, citing a source familiar with the matter. Bolton's lawyer responded in his own letter saying that House managers are seeking Bolton's testimony in President Trump's impeachment trial, and if he testifies, much of what he says will be similar to what he wrote in the book, The Room Where It Happened, a White House memoir. Bolton reportedly wrote that Trump told him he wanted to withhold congressionally approved security aid to Ukraine to get the country's leaders to investigate Democrats. This is according to CNN. Number three, Trump signs updated accord to replace NAFTA. President Trump signed the U.S.-Mexico-Canada USMCA trade pact on Wednesday in a White House ceremony with representatives from Canada and Mexico and about 400 other guests. The White House declined to invite any of the House Democrats who helped secure Trump his biggest trade deal. Mexico's parliament has ratified the deal, as has Congress, but Canada needs to approve it before it takes effect, likely in a few months. Quote, the White House hasn't invited House Democrats to their USMCA signing ceremony, end quote, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, Democrat of California, office said in a statement, quote, but we'll be represented in the huge changes to the original USMCA draft that Democrats sold out of the administration on labor, prescription drugs, environment, and enforcement mechanisms, end quote. This is according to Reuters and the Associated Press. Number four, international sporting events canceled in China as coronavirus spreads. The World Indoor Championships for track and field, previously scheduled for March 13th through 15th in Nanjing, China, have been postponed for a year as the death toll from a ballooning coronavirus outbreak surpassed 170. Olympic qualifying events for women's soccer and women's basketball were also moved to other countries, but China's women's soccer team was quarantined in Australia because it had passed through the epicenter of Wuhan. Women's Olympic soccer qualifying matches for Australia, China, Taiwan, and Thailand, which had been set to be held in Wuhan, then transferred to Nanjing, were rescheduled to take place in Sydney in February. Also on Wednesday, three airlines canceled all flights to and from mainland China, while others cut their flight numbers. This is according to the New York Times and Reuters. Number 5. Fed holds interest rates firm as expected. The Federal Reserve said Wednesday that it was holding interest rates steady as moderate economic growth and strong job gains continued. The move was widely expected. Quote, "We believe the current stance of monetary policy is appropriate to support sustained economic growth, a strong labor market, and inflation returning to our symmetric 2% objective." End quote. Fed Chair Jerome Powell said, following the central bank's two-day policy meeting, its first in 2020. The Fed last year cut rates three times, but President Trump has accused Fed leaders of holding back growth by failing to reduce rates faster and deeper. Powell also said the Fed was, quote, "very carefully monitoring," end quote, potential problems, including the possibility of economic fallout from the coronavirus outbreak that started in China. This is according to Reuters. Number 6. EU lawmakers approve terms of Britain's exit from trading bloc. European Union lawmakers on Wednesday overwhelmingly approved the terms of Britain's exit from the trading bloc in a final vote. The reluctant approval by all 28 EU countries paved the way for the UK to leave on January 31st. Quote, "We will always love you and we will never be far," end quote, said EU Commission President Ursula von der Leyen after the vote. Britain's exit on Friday after 47 years in the EU will mark the first time a member nation has left. Quote, "That's it. It's all over," end quote, said Nigel Farage, who helped lead the Brexit campaign. EU member nations said they feared talks on a new trade deal with Britain could collapse later this year, which could lead to a chaotic divorce. This is according to the Associated Press. Number 7. Dylan Roof's lawyer appealed death sentence for Charleston church massacre. Dylan Roof's lawyers portrayed him as, quote, "disconnected from reality," end quote, in a filing appealing his death sentence for killing 9 people at a historically black church in Charleston, South Carolina. Roof represented himself at his 2017 trial for the 2015 massacre at Mother Emmanuel AME Church, despite being, quote, a 22-year-old ninth grade dropout diagnosed with schizophrenia spectrum disorder, autism, anxiety, and depression, who believed his sentence didn't matter because white nationalists would free him from prison after an impending race war, end quote, his lawyer said in the filing. Quote, "Roof's crime was tragic, but this court can have no confidence in the jury's verdict," end quote, the attorneys wrote. U.S. District Judge Richard Gergel told Roof during his trial it was, quote, "strategically unwise," end quote, to represent himself, but, quote, "it is a decision you have a right to make," end quote. This is according to CNN and The Hill. Number 8. Roberts blocks question naming alleged Ukraine whistleblower. Chief Justice John Roberts on Wednesday blocked a question from Senator Rand Paul, Republican of Kentucky, naming the alleged whistleblower whose complaint about President Trump's phone call with Ukrainian President Vladimir Zelensky triggered the House impeachment inquiry. Paul has strongly opposed the impeachment proceedings against Trump and has floated the alleged whistleblower's name in recent interviews. Roberts, who screens questions submitted for reading on the Senate floor during Trump's trial on abuse of power and obstruction charges, signaled earlier this week that he would not allow anyone to mention the whistleblower's name during the questioning of House impeachment managers and Trump's defense team. Paul has said he just wants to ask a question on why the Ukrainian investigation was launched. This is according to Politico. Number 9, Japan issues arrest warrants over Gozan's escape. Japanese authorities on Thursday issued arrest warrants for 3 people, including a former U.S. Special Forces soldier, on suspicion that they helped former Nissan chief Carlos Ghosn flee Japan ahead of his trial, alleged financial crimes. The warrants target former U.S. Green Beret Michael Taylor and 2 other men, George Antoine Zayek and Peter Taylor, prosecutors said. Another warrant was issued for Ghosn, who fled to Lebanon late last year as he awaited trial for allegedly underreporting his earnings and misappropriating company money. He denies all of the charges and says he fled because he wasn't going to get a fair trial. Lebanon and Japan have no extradition treaty. Lebanon, where Ghosn spent much of his childhood and has citizenship, typically doesn't send its citizens for trial abroad. This is according to Reuters. Number 10. Kobe Bryant's widow, Vanessa Bryant, shares family's grief. Vanessa Bryant on Wednesday evening posted her first public statement since her husband, Los Angeles Lakers legend Kobe Bryant, their 13-year-old daughter Gianna, and 7 others were killed in a helicopter crash Sunday. On Instagram, Bryant thanked the, quote, millions of people who've shown support and love during this horrific time, end quote. She said her 3 surviving daughters were, quote, completely devastated by the sudden loss of Kobe and Gianna, and there, quote, aren't enough words to describe our pain right now. I take comfort in knowing that Kobe and Gigi both knew that they were so deeply loved. We were so incredibly blessed to have them in our lives. I wish they were here with us forever. They were our beautiful blessings taken from us too soon, end quote. This is according to Vanessa Bryant and ABC News. That's 10 things you need to know today for Thursday, January 30th, 2020. If you'd like to tell your story, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Find it everywhere using the hashtag What Makes You Famous. That's it for this edition of What Makes You Smarter. I hope you learned something. I sure did. This is Keys Dan with RadioWhat.com, DJLittleRock.com. Peace. I'm out of here. If you like what you hear, I encourage you to follow What Makes You Smarter on social media. Find it on Facebook at What Makes You Smarter, Instagram at What Makes You Smarter, Twitter at Smarter What, and YouTube. Username Keys Dan. Leave What Makes You Smarter podcast a review and subscribe. Listen to What Makes You Smarter podcast on Spotify, iTunes, YouTube, Stitcher, Google Podcasts, and Podcast Addict, my personal favorite. Learn with me on my podcast, What Makes You Smarter. And if you'd like to tell your story, I encourage you to check out my other podcast, What Makes You Famous. Find it everywhere using the hashtag What Makes You Famous. Call 501-470-6386. And leave a message to set up a time for What Makes You Famous. Support What Makes You Smarter podcast using the PayPal, paypal.me/KeysDan. Email info@RadioWhat.com. What Makes You Smarter is a production of Keys Dan Enterprises Incorporated at KeysDan.com. Thank you for listening. Thank you for listening. Thank you for listening.